Promote to a bishop or a knight. Okay. Knight e6 with a threat. Queen g5, knight takes e4, looks good. Oh, did I blunder something? Oops. High five, thank you for the 18 months in a row. Now I'm threatening to take on g6. Oof. Rook here, rook c1, rook c8, check. Threatening knight takes e7 mate. Eric is an artist. Well, that's a compliment. I don't attract the artist, though. I'm not part of that artistic circle, you know? I'm not part of the art cliques. Trying to gain a bit of space on the flank. I've been playing such poor online chess. I'm hoping things start to improve. I want to remove the knight on e3 because that is defending this pawn on d5. Because this is a public player, Ronin95. It's his name, and he just didn't add a title to it or something. So it's a public name with a title, but the title's not attached to the account. Yeah, he's a GM. Is he a GM? I didn't even know that. Just knew he was a strong player. Aram Hakobian is a grandmaster, 2545, born in 2001. Dar Pajoji, that is, I don't think you understand how the rating system works. You need 2500 for GM. For 2600 performances, I have a lot, but GM's only 2500, so. I want to play bishop. I'm doing something weird. I want to win this pawn, but the problem is he has this tactic when he wins the pawn. What? Okay, now I can take and then take. E7's defended. Push the center. It's a good move by him. Don't give me too much counterplay. Thinking about. Darpaj, I don't think you're understanding what people are saying. $2,600 plus is in the top 15% of GMs. So, it's out of all the GMs, it's near the top. Oh. Bosk, thank you for the 19 months, buddy. And that's a, 19 months, Twitch Prime. I mean, GMs like, I don't know, Amon and Andrew Tang are under 2,500. There's lots of GMs like that. So there's a really wide range among GMs. And 2,600 is not great, but it's in the top 10-15% out of all GMs. So they can make new titles, but out of GMs, it's already considerably higher than most. Let's put my bishop on g3. Yeah, I have to take. He wants to play queen d5, and I don't blame him. Okay, here, I don't mind playing this position. I just need to get my queen side majority rolling. Something, thank you for the 8 months, by the way. High five, thank you for the 18 months. All of 10 as... $3, love the channel. Thank you, Olive. Sorry for missing that. So, I'm not going to trade yet. My rook over to d1. I'm threatening knight d7. Well, knight d7 before queen e4, he trades queens, so I'm only forking his bishop and knight. He can just move his rook after. G4, queen G7. Alright, let's start with this. Knight G4, I'm trying to induce some weaknesses, and then, yeah, that's a good move by him. I don't want to trade queens, not when he's weakened his king side. Alright, here I have to take. It's a no-brainer. Up, I'm guessing. Check. Here. Okay. Here. Take the only open file. I have a 3-on-1 on one side of the board, which is a good thing. Let's trade. King here, huh? Here? King there. Rook here. Check. Check. Here. 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 Now I'm winning, I think. Two connected passed pawns. Should be winning. Yes! There we go. Big win. Just a bandwagon fan. Appreciate the 9 months. Comfortable position for white. I've given him the center, given him everything, and that's not what you want to do. This is a poor game. A very, very poor game on my end. Go from a good game to a bad game very quickly. Pain Pita, thanks for gifting the sub there. Waste of an opening. I gave white way too much counterplay here. Okay, queen a5 is just asking for way too much. Can't prevent the queens from being traded. Take g6. I don't understand that move at all. Take. Take. e2. Okay. My hands are cold. Hashtag cold hands. Let's take there. Push. Bring my king in. I want to challenge the 7th rank. Hopefully, my two passed pawns pushed. Yep. Check. Oof. Just in time. I probably could have done better there, but I had no time. D4 pawn is going to be targeted. I want to play B5 and undermine this pawn as soon as I can. Here. What's the move? Someone help me out. Knight takes. Queen F1. Okay, we can do it. Queen takes c3, knight e7 check is a move. Knight e7 check. Bishop here. Okay. So f5 is a move. I'm looking at rook b3. Maybe rook e7. No, how about queen here? And rook b8. Rook b8 strong. Because then I have this knight e7, queen g8 mating idea. Try to keep his queen on c3 out of the game. If rook f8, then I'm gonna take. Well, here. It's gonna go. Okay, I have. Okay, I guess this wins. And then knight takes d5. Had a position like this once in Gibraltar. Take. Something like knight here. Now b4. Let's go b4. Oh. I'll happily trade. I'm surprised he's giving me that. Very surprised. Enrique, slow down, please. Please slow down. I just want to trade rooks off. Trading rooks off would be a big plus. Remove his tactical firepower. Now we can go back. Now let's go for an endgame. Let's play a little faster and go for the endgame here. My pawns are in the right color for the endgame. If I get the queens and the rooks off, this is a lost position. Poljan, thank you. Welcome. Pain Peter, thanks for gifting that. What are we gonna do? What else to do? Trading everything, huh? Okay. We can do that. We We can see how that goes. Rook c8, keep it simple if you're playing black here. Queen e7, I take on b5, and I play rook a5. I'll play rook a5 anyways. Queen b6 isn't really ideal. Maybe he's gonna do it. Okay. I think I have time for this. Queen here might be annoying, eh? Then maybe knight f5. Okay, let's see how knight f5 goes. Try to get rid of his light squared bishop. Fair. I can take on d5. I guess I have to. If he takes on c2, I can take on e4. Takes h6, rook takes f6, and this looks strong. No? Maybe I underestimated it. Play knight takes f6 mate. Could have done that in a much trickier way. I should have done knight e4 first. Dumb. Very dumb. Much better variation there. I'm gonna flag. That was so silly. Oh. Oh. Messed up that move order there. Knight takes e4 before. Before. That was very silly of me. Out. Oh my that's a decent move. Okay. I'll take it. I'll take it. Could have been worse. Forgot. It was a blunder, but it might work. We'll take it. Unintentional blunders are always welcome, guys. Always. What's up, Distant Fire? If the queen took the knight, I'd take on d4. I had the right idea. Queen B6, no. It's castle. I'm gonna take, play Queen A5. His pawns are our targets. Knight E3 is tempting. We'll go Knight E3. Bring all the pieces to the yard. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, exactly. Exactly. My milkshakes are coming. I hope you guys are ready to enjoy. Go. All the milkshakes. Dr. Robotnik, 41 months. RG bait. Dr. Robotnik, thank you, thank you. Gotta bring out the bamboo stick, guys. You've never seen 41 months? You haven't seen a guy like Dr. Robotnik. He's quiet these days, but he used to be a top tier shit poster. Dude, I need to study chess. I don't get anything against these openings ever. Because you need to actually study to beat these solid structures. You have to put in hard work, dedication. So this is an interesting position because he's got a damaged pawn structure, but at the same time, this pawn on c5 controls my majority. It's not going to be easy to make a passed pawn. I'm thinking of putting my bishop on c3. What do you guys think about that? That looks... So now, yeah, that makes sense. All right, bishop takes h6. Bishop takes h6. Well, what do you know? Bishop takes h6 works. It's not as simple as it seems, though. He has rook 88, queen g4, bishop f6. Okay. Fine. Fine. Rook 88. Queen here. Oh, I didn't see that move. Well, shit. Where the hell did that move come from? Rook e4, bishop takes e4. I'm not threatening anything. Queen g3, bishop d6. Holy smokes. Okay. Okay. This guy is punishing the hell out of me here. This is what happens. I shouldn't have done bishop h6. I just, for the cost of an h-pawn, I'm getting things I didn't sign up for. No, I'm gonna lose. Oh, you can just take. No, this is a very depressing way to. Okay, that's such a waste of the white pieces. I honestly didn't want to play that move, but I thought that, for the purposes of a Friday night stream, I should. My momentum is disappearing. Is this theory? I think it's queen d7. Huh? I'll pretend this is something. No, but it's like, I clearly wasn't going to checkmate my opponent, so all I did was I made... It's very easy for him to play. If you're going to lose a pawn and get all that activity, I mean, yeah, it just became very, very straightforward. Oh, now I'm getting, things are happening, nasty things are happening. Thank you for the reset, FAP9, with the sub. Onwards and upwards. Onwards and upwards. Okay. I played a very bad move. He had bishop here and bishop d6. I'm playing like such a trash can. Bishop here. Alright. We're playing on the light squares here, guys. Hey, pretty boy junior, how you doing? Playing like a bum. I'm playing like a bum. Yep. I have a queenside majority that must be pushed. If it doesn't get pushed, I'm in for a very long night. A very long night. Chess bum. That's me. I'm up on time though. Ooh. A maximalist, huh? I'm gonna jam my bishop on d3 if you invite me, okay? Okay. Okay, okay, okay. You got it, pal. Why queen here? Well, let's bring my pieces towards the center. This is a good position. Ooh. Oof. This is not how you play. This is not how you play. I'm gonna get a good knight. Okay. Continue. B Be careful where you put your queen. There's some bad endgames up ahead. I envision my rook on g6, my knight on e4. What do you guys envision? So king h7, king here. Start there. If king h1, yes. Queen d5 is a good move. Oh shit. I didn't see that. Holy shit. Oh, you gotta be shitting me. What the flying heck just happened? That came out of nowhere, dude. Dude! Okay, now I'm threatening mate. Oh, those are some... I gotta give him some respect. Unfortunately, the respect can only go so far. I'm gonna also give a nasty checkmate. But! I like those moves. I like some of the moves I'm seeing.